Speed Force Spectre here. So my Minions video, a lot of people really like that video. People really like the quote I said. I said, you know, Illumination, Minions, Despicable Me, whatever you want to loop that conversation into about the company or the movies or whatever. It was mainly a discussion more so about Despicable Me than anything. But, you know, I said, you know, for me, I don't really care that Despicable Me doesn't move animation forward. The cool thing is, it moved me forward. And people really liked that quote. Not to mention, the thing that I'm getting a lot from that video is people really loved the human side of that video. And that's the one thing, ever since my very first video, it's no longer up, but I have archived it. I definitely want to not make a commentary on the video. I definitely want to upload it as it is, but I do want to make a video on how important it is. But that was like the very first video that definitely told me to definitely be very straightforward, be myself with you guys. Be as human possibly can. That's the thing, I gotta admit, that's the thing that, for me, in terms of, really, in the real world, things are just not, they're not great. Some days are better than others, but, you know, I'm just like, I'm put down a lot, I'm judged, you know, there's just a lot of not pretty things I've gone through, and definitely because of that, in a lot of recent years, I've suffered through a lot of anxiety, a lot of depression, just a lot of not so great things that I don't want anybody to ever go through. And because of that, I've had, in the past years, I've had a lot of self-hatred, and I've learned to, you know, definitely love myself. Some days are better than others, but, you know, I've definitely learned that, and because of that, I will say this, fandoms can be a good thing, and fandoms can be a bad thing. Y'all kind of already know that, you know, if you've been on the internet for a long time, you kind of know that. You don't know when a fandom discourse is going to happen, but it's going to happen at some point, and it's kind of funny with me, like, I can handle fandom discourse, and, like, kind of, like, at the end of the day, I'm like, I'm still me, that's a-okay, that's all that matters. But when it comes down to the animation community, I don't feel that. You know, I feel, in the past years, I've just felt bad for being in the animation community. And it was in the past. It was never good on my mental health and my mental state. A really great example of this is feeling like I have to prove that I'm normal. I'm like everyone else in the community. And a huge example is definitely how people present their opinions on things. And you know, a good example of that is definitely Illumination and Despicable Me. As I said earlier, you know, I said I don't care that Illumination or not Illumination or whatever, Minions, whatever, doesn't move animation forward, but it definitely moved me forward. You know, ages ago, long time ago, early 2010s, but definitely when we got into like the 2013s and stuff, you know, saying a statement like that, I would have been afraid to be eaten alive by the animation community, because that's not a normal statement from the animation community at all whatsoever. Something, if I said something like that would be a statement that would be definitely frowned upon. And that was never good on my mental state, so I had to lie about it. Now, the good thing is I never made animation community videos at the time. Thank God I never did. Oh my goodness. Because I would have been lying to all of y'all. But, you know, I made, I don't know, like, I guess I made. I mean, you can't really find the tweets of it because my old Twitter account got deleted. But I think probably I made tweets saying I hated Illumination or something along those lines. I probably said some dumb baloney like that, faking it till I made it, type of stuff, because I was afraid of, you know, saying, you know, my true feelings, that I did in my Minions video. You know, saying something like that, you know, years ago I would not have been able to say, because that's just not normal in the animation community to really say. And like, for example, another good example of something I really love, DreamWorks Trolls. The animation community cannot stand trolls. And because of it, you know, I always felt out of place. I always definitely felt like I didn't belong because trolls is my jam, trolls is my obsession. And because the animation community really, really couldn't stand it in terms of how they presented their opinions and everything else like that, you know, and definitely being in the fandom, I've definitely seen people use a lot of the animation community's reviews on it and definitely weaponize it to bully DreamWorks Trolls fans. I have seen that happen and it's awful. It was not a good feeling at all whatsoever. And it definitely just made it feel like I didn't belong in the community because of how people presented their views and mindset. And I want to present this. I'm not saying people should fake and say Trolls is good. Oh, no. Opinions are a good thing. Good, bad, indifferent, whatever. I'm a content creator, so, you know, I definitely, everyone needs the feedback. But the most important thing is, you know, you don't really see the human side. There, in my opinion, you don't really see human empathy in the animation community. In how they present their opinions, views, and mindsets. And again, as I stated, for me, the animation community was just kind of, it was really just not good on my mental health because of how definitely the community presented itself. And because of that, when I made my videos, I kind of made a promise to myself in that very first video that I ever made. And because I'm bringing it up, I'm definitely going to post that video. That video told me to, you know what, you need to be real with your audience, but you need to have that human empathy when talking to your viewers. No matter how my opinions are, good, bad, indifferent, whatever, I need to respect my viewers, respect that they're human too. There's a human behind that screen. And also, like a studio or a creator, you know, whatever. You know, you never know who's watching, and you never know what people go through. You don't know how they feel. And I definitely think the animation community, whether you make videos or you make Twitter posts, you really never know what someone's going through. You don't know how they feel, and you know how you present yourself. You gotta think, you know, you kind of can't really go around willy-nilly saying whatever. You gotta be sure to watch yourself. And definitely watch how you use your voice. If you're making, if you're making content like I am, like reviews, you know, you definitely have to definitely watch your voice, you know, because that presentation of your voice or whatever, or how you say it, you know, that's gonna make or break, how a viewer will perceive you. And really, that was kind of the things that very much deteriorated my a lot of my feelings because of how people presented themselves. And I feel like really for me, the human side of my reviews, is it definitely it's important, and I feel like the animation community, the things that really I feel like were like the bad sides of the community that I saw, you people probably, if you don't see this in the animation community, thank God. Thank God. Because y'all need to have fun. Y'all need to have fun in the animation community. But the things that I personally saw in the animation community and the things that definitely were not good on my mental health and a lot of other things, it taught me a lot in how I should definitely make my videos. Because if I'm being honest, in terms of the animation community, I don't like the animation community. You can kind of tell that because of, what I'm saying about my mental health and what it did. You could tell I'm not, I have a really distaste for it. But you know what? At the end of the day, you know what I could say? I like animation fans. I don't like the animation community. I just like animation fans. And if you're part of the animation community, I love you. If you're part of the animation community, I love you. But in terms of just, I feel like I don't like the late, I guess I don't like the label of animation community. So I guess, I don't like the label animation community, and I don't like what I've seen and what it's done to me natively. So I'll go with that. I guess that's a better, I guess that's a better way to do it. Because if I'm being honest, I am fandom exhausted of the animation community. And same with my other fandoms. Not saying I'm leaving or anything like that. But like I'm just fandom exhausted. I would rather do my own thing, kind of just ignore what other people say. Not saying like not like ignore, but if you kind of can understand what I'm coming from. I don't know how to word it, but it's kind of it's more easy to kind of just be myself and have my own fun, and have fun with others, because I've met a lot of amazing people in the animation community, and especially during when in real life is tough for me, or I'm going through a day of where I'm just like I'm really, really down. There's a lot of people in the animation community that, they've really been amazing. They've done a great job to make me happy, make me smile, feel normal. And, it's kind of, the one thing that I feel a lot, I definitely feel like I'm not normal. I definitely feel like, I don't fit in places. And, when the people I know in the animation community can make me feel normal, that's that is always a good thing for me. And yeah. I don't know where else to go with this, but that's definitely why, me being human and like really raw with my emotions in my reviews, I feel like it's just really important because, I definitely want, people to kind of know me in a sense, but like also know how I feel about fandom stuff, and also animation, or other things, It doesn't really matter what it is in terms of my fandom taste or whatever video I make. I definitely always, I definitely want kind of people to know that, A, whatever I say, be yourself, be your own specter. Which if, If this is the first time kind of knowing what Spectre is, pretty much it means ghost, which, that's part of it. I mean, we're all kind of ghost experiencing media. The creator or characters or whatever, no matter the media, no one really knows who's experiencing it. So we're all technically ghost experiencing media. But it also comes from the term, spectate, which just means watch or experience. And we're all just our own specters. We experience media in our own way, and I feel like that's kind of the thing I want with my audience, is to know me, how I feel about things, but kind of also have their own opinion. I feel like I want there to be that room, for people to kind of express how they feel. Because, with me in terms of the animation community, I feel like there's really like this judge, jury, executioner type of thing. Whatever I say, kind of, it's that's that, And you kind of feel uncomfortable saying how you really feel because you don't know how people are going to respond. It kind of goes back to my views on Illumination slash Despicable Me. If someone is kind of presenting themselves in a way that definitely feels like it's like really, really rude to the audience member, what's the point in commenting and saying your opinion if you're kind of afraid of how that person's going to react? And it could be the nicest person in the world, but like you don't know because of how they kind of threw their views out there, and it kind of feels like, judge, jury, executioner, I just laid the hammer down, And yeah, I kind of hope this kind of explained everything. I feel like this kind of turned into my gripes with the animation community, but like my gripes with it are kind of the reason why I make the videos I do. So anyway, I'm Speed Force Spectre, and I'm signing out.